टुडे वील रिवाइज योर हिस्ट्री चैप्टर 1 द फ्रेंच रेवोल्यूशन. ओके, तो दिस स्टोरी स्टार्ट्स इन द ईयर 1774 व्हेन किंग लुईस 16 बिकेम द रूलर ऑफ फ्रांस. When he became the ruler of France, the treasury was empty and he felt the burden of the financial resources in the country. So he increased the taxes on the people of France. Just because the people were already facing the subsistence crisis because the prices were already high and the King Louis XVI increased the taxes on the people. Especially the third estate, the conditions became worst. You already know, we have discussed in the videos also, your Zoom classes also, the French society was divided into three estates. So first estate and the second estate, they belong to the clergy and the royal family, the nobles. And the third estate, who comprised the peasants and the labor class, were the people who had to pay all the taxes. So when the taxes were increased by Louis XVI, the people were angry and annoyed. So what happened on July 14th, 1789, the people gathered at one place and they attacked the Bastille. Bastille was a fortress prison. It was a fort that was being used as a prison by the king that was attacked by the mob, the crowd. And peasants in the urban, rural areas also, in the countryside, also revolted. So, people of the third estate, because annoyed with the king, they attacked the Bastille and freed all the prisoners who were captured in the fortress prison of Bastille. On 1789, the third estate, the people who gathered in one place to form the National Assembly. And that assembly in 1791 framed a constitution. This constitution focused on granting the basic rights to all the human beings, though they belong to any estate in France. The first category, second category, and the third estate or category, who belonged to the very poor people or the underprivileged people in the country and who had to pay all the taxes and were not having any political or social rights, those people were granted the basic or fundamental rights equally to the first and second estate. Secondly, under this constitution, the powers of the king were limited. Okay, the king agreed on the terms that his powers will be limited and he will take the major decisions of the country after discussing with the panel or a group of people. Without their permission or without discussing with the National Assembly, he will not take any decisions. The years 1792 and 93 were the years of the great chaos in France, and France removing the monarch from throwing the monarch out of the power became a republic. The king later was beheaded, was caught and beheaded, means he was executed, killed. The years 1793 and 94, they are called a reign of terror, matlab atank ka shasan. This period was the period when the Jacobin Republic ruled in France. This was the Jacobin was the group, political group of those people from the third estate and the you can say the people from the middle class families who belong to the third estate. Un logon ka ek group tha, Jacobin club. So that club was led by Maximilian Robespierre. 1793 and 94 was the period when Maximilian Robespierre formed the government of Jacobins as Jacobin Republic and ruled France. But he, the way he implemented the democratic values and the welfare measures for the people, those methods were not right. Though he wanted the welfare of the common people, the third estate, they wanted to give all people the equal rights, but the methods he adopted, the way he implemented his policies were not right. The people took him as suppressive, his policies as oppressive and terrible, full of terror. So the rule of Jacobin Republic or Maximilian Robespierre was the rule of the reign of terror. These people were not happy the way he were implementing his policies and strategies to give the democratic rights to the people. Slowly he turned into a ruler like a dictator. In 1804, Before Napoleon became the emperor of the France, a directory was set up. A directory of the five people where the National Assembly was set up. Maximilian Robespierre was also removed from the power and he was also executed. And after him, a directory of five members were formed who ruled France. Okay. And after that directory, even because there were many people to decide about the things of the about the policy, the matters of the France, and there were always disagreement between the people. So Napoleon became the emperor, declared himself the emperor of France in 1804. He was a military leader, okay, in France who got the power in 1804. He just followed the policy of expansion. He started attacking the neighboring countries, neighboring areas to expand the territories of France. But at Waterloo in 1815, he was defeated. 1848 was the year when slavery was abolished in France. That is one more practice which was very popular in European countries in those times. We'll discuss in the next video. Okay. There are now the two types of taxes also, teeth and tails, which were introduced, which were charged from the third estate in France. Teeth was the tax which was collected by the church. And tail was the tax which was directly paid to the state, to the king. It was paid to the church, teeth and tail. So the people were not able to pay these taxes, so they revolted, and this revolt started with the Bastille attack in 1789. There are now few philosophers or the thinkers who played a very important role in the French Revolution. Montesquieu, Rousseau, Absies, John Locke. Okay, they wrote books also. You have to learn the names of the books also for your exam also. So Montesquieu was that person who wrote The Spirit of the Laws. He's also a philosopher and a thinker. In there. Rousseau, an educationist also, philosopher also. He wrote the book The Social Contract. Third is Absies. Absies was the leader of the National Assembly who wrote the book What is Third Estate. John Locke played also an important role in awaiting the people of France in bringing the revolution. The book was Two Treaties of the Government. And this was the Marseillaise, the song was sung for the very first time by the National Assembly as a song to inspire people for the revolution. Later it became the national song of France. This is the national song of France, Marseillaise. Okay, the next half of the chapter we will discuss in the second video. Thank you.